Hello everyone, and welcome back to Art Smart. I'm Kevin Hogan. Andy Warhol is oftentimes referred to by various people on the internet, and I do a lot of looking at art on the internet, as a hack. A lot of people look at Andy Warhol, who did most of his popular works during the 1960s, is largely viewed by a large portion of the art viewing population as being somebody that just took things from other people, repackaged it, and tries to make it his own. A lot of people say that this makes him a hack. And if you look at some of his most popular works, it's easy to see why people would say that. If you look at Andy Warhol, his most famous works are prints of Marilyn Monroe, which he didn't take those pictures. He just reprinted it and used color to present Marilyn Monroe in these different states. His Barillo box is one of the more famous works that he did. And of course, the Campbell Soup cans are among his most famous works. Now, if you look at works like that, you could see, yeah, maybe there is some validity to the people that say that Andy Warhol was a hack. However, I have three separate reasons why I would disagree with that statement, and I'd like to tell you about it today. The first thing is, if you look at Andy Warhol's work, he actually did make several pieces that were very original that were on his own. If you look at his early work, he did a lot of work that was in graphic design, where he was designing pieces to be sold on a consumer basis. And a lot of these designs that I will show you here are quite original, and they're very interesting. They have a very fine graphic quality, almost illustrative. There's a whimsical quality to it. And he has a definitely unique use of line in it, making very bold statements using very simple lines, which is wonderful. He was also a filmmaker, and when he had his different films, some people look at them as being boring, such as the film Sleep, which is, I believe, 6 hours worth of somebody sleeping. However, at the time, it was an original idea to show something like somebody sleeping and try to make an artistic statement about it. So I do think Andy Warhol has been somewhat misunderstood in being somebody who didn't create anything truly original. He did. Secondly, I think most people that are looking at Andy Warhol and making these criticisms to him don't realize that he was doing something different and new with changing other people's works. He wanted people to really look at pop culture and the various consumer things that we do on a daily basis and ask ourselves how we truly felt about it. The question being is, when we are looking at a work that has been created for a consumer product, such as McDonald's or a TV ad, is it okay for us to think that the design is cool? Is it okay the fact that we all know what the McDonald's symbol is, but most of us don't necessarily know most of the works made by a guy like Rembrandt? Is it okay for us to have an emotional attachment to a consumer product and not to have an emotional attachment to something like Michelangelo's David? He wanted people to look at the consumer products as art themselves and ask themselves, is it okay for us to feel this way? He's actually asking you to engage in it. So by changing it and making these very consumer-friendly things more interesting to look at, he's saying, is it okay for us to celebrate something that is meant to be consumed and thrown away? And when you're looking at like the Marilyn Monroe portrait, she was very much somebody that was consumed by the public and then thrown away when she no longer was getting the same roles that she was when she was younger. This is a very interesting subject for a lot of people in art, and so some people just don't get that. They just look at the piece itself being not very original in the fact that he didn't take the original painting or whatever, or the original picture or whatever. But that's not necessarily what Andy Warhol was doing. He was changing the product in order to make us think about the product. The last thing that I'd like to bring up is the fact that he actually had a huge impact on popular culture when it comes to music. He was an avant-garde artist, and he definitely wanted people to look at music in a very different way. What could music do? How does sound move us? Are we okay with music being cool just because it looks cool on stage and not necessarily listening to the substance of the music itself? And groups that he supported, such as the Velvet Underground, had a big impact on the way that we look at different groups. If you like somebody like a David Bowie, you are actually really celebrating someone like Andy Warhol, because David Bowie was somebody who a lot of the time was celebrating using visuals and using a stage presence to move you. Whether or not you like his music or not, he definitely impacted you. Alice Cooper, many other different groups, I could go on and on. Lady Gaga, all kinds of people were celebrating the fact that Andy Warhol wanted you to think about what you were listening to and the visuals that you see, and making a new art form out of those combinations of weird, strange images and sounds. So I think he is a very important artist. I think he is somebody that was truly an original, even if not every aspect of his work was all that original. And no, I don't think he's a hack. Maybe not every work that he did was the most difficult piece to do, but there was always a interesting thought process behind it. Hopefully this explanation makes you a little bit more art smart, and you'll come back to hear a little bit more about other artists throughout history. Bye-bye.